Hello everybody, my name is Peter Tottrup from NLIR, and I will be talking about using visual sensors for mid-infrared spectroscopy. Here at NLIR, we make super fast and ultra-sensitive mid-infrared sensors that are based upon a non-linear infrared upconversion, hence the name. So why upconvert to a vis or near? The primary molecular vibrations resides in the mid-infrared, and the materials for detectivity in the visual are better than in the mid-infrared. So by using these silicon or whatever visual near detection materials for mid-infrared light, you get the best of both worlds. And the way we do it is that we have the mid-infrared light and we upconvert the interaction through a nonlinear upconversion process to 700 to 1000 nanometer and detect with a vis near sensor. And here is one of our products where you have the input to the left and the upconversion and then a kind of a standard grading spectrometer optimized to this process. So we kind of take the global fiber spectrometer portfolio beyond near infrared by enabling 2 to 5.3 nanometer for our fiber spectrometer. So our product is a very unprecedented combination with 400 spectra per second, with a good resolution of 5 inverse, and a very, very sensitive 10 picowatt per nanometer. And just here recently, we have made a new product introduced where we can do all the way up to 130 kilohertz with also still with a good resolution and a good detectivity or sensitivity. Probably, as we say in Denmark, probably the best spectrometer in the world for this. And here are some of the measurements we have done with our fiber spectrometer. We have done some coatings measurements, food storage gas analysis, and recently also some 80 kilohertz laser characterization when you have the modulated laser up to 80 kilohertz. And so here are some of the many applications you can use our spectrometer for. Combustion, gas analysis, coating, foils, composite materials, reflection and transmission stuff. We also do single wavelength detectors, very extremely sensitive down to femtowatts, root square hertz, or up to 10 gigahertz or maybe more. But we do that for a single wavelength. And then now we have a new feature we can also tune between 2.7 and 4.5 micrometer. And here are some of the measurements we have done with our detectors. Some ultra-sensitive detection for combustion analysis, photon counting, down to 10,000 counts per second in the mid-infrared. We have done 10 gigahertz detectors for chemical kinetics. And some customers also bought it because of the extreme high response. And here are some of the many vis near sensors we have mid-infrared enabled, spanning from OCT near spectrometers to CCDs and CMOSes, and also some 10 gigahertz gallium arsenide, APDs, photon counters and stuff. So this is what I would tell you about today. So thank you for listening and please put in a chat if you have a question.